Hey guys, today I'm going to be reviewing The Rite of Spring. It was wrote by Igor Stravinsky, and it was interpreted into a ballet of primitive dances, and apparently it wasn't very good, and a lot of people revolted. So Fantasia decided to put it how it's originally made, the story of our planet's beginning. So without further ado, The Rite of Spring. A long time ago, in our galaxy, not so far, far away. There it is, our home galaxy, the Milky Way. A nebula, the space cloud where stars are born. A red-hot star. Some stars become this way when it's time for them to die. Then they combust, which form, their ruins form new nebulas. And that's when stars are reborn. Comets. And as we see more space comets and nebulas, we come approaching our little planet. Or how it began. The beginning of our little planet. We're approaching Earth to what it was like billions and billions of years ago, before we were all even born. It was all a bunch of volcanoes and stuff. So basically, it's kind of like a discount Mustafar, without life forms or mining facilities. On the surface of the Earth are volcanoes, the Earth's pimples. And it looks like they're getting ready to erupt. With molten hot lava and steaming magma. Thank you. They all erupted, except for that one. Looks like a storm's a-brewing. Many years later, the first life forms appeared on Earth. We were all tiny, microscopic single-cell beings swimming around the water. Billions of years ago. So this guy met another guy, and then the numbers begin increasing, which led to the first invertebrates on Earth. The polyps and hydroids would feed off the drifting microscopic life that passed by. As time went on, more invertebrates came, this time more mobile. Which led to the first vertebrates on Earth, leading to the theory of evolution. So that fish escaped the jellyfish's clutches and one day grew and grew and crawled out of the water with his mutant fish hands and then gained some limbs, becoming the first amphibian, soon leading into the first reptile. Which brings us to the next chapter, the beginning of the dinosaur era. Many dinos come in shapes and sizes, small as a dog to as big as a bus. Some dwell in the land, some dwell in the water. Some are herbivorous, and others are carnivorous. Some have tall necks, some have short necks. Some walk on twos, some walk on all fours. Pterodactyls. The winged dinosaurs who dwell the sky. They're looking for some fish and cephalopods to eat for dinner. And so, they swoop into action. Looks like he got some. Oh, and they're fighting over it. This one, however, is not so lucky, as the predator dinosaur got him by the neck just as he got his snack. Many dinos live in lush jungles. For example, the Dimetrodon. An Ankylosaurus. And the Triceratops. That predator dino is going after that small guy. But he escaped. That was the first bird dino. A group of raptor-shaped dinos. Getting some drinks at the watering hole. I am a Stegosaurus! Many dinos were armed with powerful weapons. The Parasaurolophus. A duck-billed herbivore. Some baby triceratops. These dinos are burying their eggs in the ground to incubate them. Since that's his egg, Holo Guy, so beat it. What's that? It's probably nothing. But then, Here's Rexy! It's the king of the dinosaur world! The big bad bully! The Tyrannosaurus Rex! He's looking for someone to pick a fight with! And a dinner to go for as well! The Tyrannosaurus Rex is related to the chicken somehow! Stego's not too fast, so Tyranno goes for him! And with a bite of the tail, the fight begins! Tyrannosaurus! Bites Stegosaurus on the neck, and Stego swings in with his armored tail! Another swing to the neck, and they begin share another glare of avarice! The other dinos spectate, watching helplessly, as Tyrannosaurus looks at Stego viciously, and bites him on the neck hard again, and another swing to the head! Another swing to the head! Tyranno has had enough and bites onto Stego's neck and does not let go! And the Stegosaurus is down for the count! And if looks could kill, Tyrannosaurus finally lets go of the Stego's head. And the Stego collapses. And gives one last breath of air. Before dying. Dun, dun, dun. And with the triumphant roar, the Tyrannosaurus emerges from the fight victorious. He told all the other dinos to beat it so he can enjoy the remains of his dinner. But then, Dinopocalypse began. There are many theories on how it happened. Some speculate massive earthquakes. Some speculate a giant meteor crash landed on the Earth. Some speculate both. However, this was the beginning of the end of the dinosaurs. Food supplies were limited. Plant life was dying quickly. Huge droughts. Wiping out many of their food supply. The dinos have time limited. So they began looking for a different place to find more food. Dust storms, wiping out their last breaths. As they helplessly collapse, slowly, one by one. There goes another! And then... all of the dinos went extinct and are now the fossilized beings of what we see them in museums today. Their remains reassembled by paleontologists who dug them up. soon after. The earth begins to shake. As the craters open up, the tectonic plates are shifting. Wind blew furiously, and floods came in. The first mountains were being born. Bringing us to our planet as we know and love today. And as the solar eclipse flashes in the sky, there you have it. That is the story. The origins of our planet and the life of the dinosaurs. Thanks for watching.